up, witches? It's Starlight out in the evening, and today's video is going to be one that was actually kind of highly requested. It's going to be a continuation of my Fae series, which is like an ongoing thing on this channel. Every time I find out new information, I bring it to you. And this one is going to be about unicorns. Unicorns. So, as usual, trusty book. And let's get going, I guess. Shall we? We shall. Let us learn. Let us gain the knowledge of the fairy beings. In a weird mood. It's good. It's fine. Unicorns are one of the most loved mystical and magical beings. Everyone is drawn to their gentle nature, youthfulness, playfulness, potent magical and healing abilities, and spiritual wisdom. They are usually described as bountiful, beautiful and graceful horse-like beings with a horn that elevates in the third eye area between the eyes. I'm gonna have to follow this because it's tiny ass writing. Though they are often depicted as pure white, unicorns are as diverse as every other unique being and come in a myriad of shapes, colours and sizes, and often with dominant features like spots or stripes. Their energy is pure and brilliant white. Unicorns teach us to honour our individuality. No two beings are the same, and unicorns help those that struggle with this truth or try to fit in with others to find their own way of getting to know themselves while bringing their individuality to a group without losing themselves. Harmony is a quality often associated with unicorns. As natural peacekeepers, unicorns are diplomatic, serene and adaptable beings who bring love, joy and peace wherever they go. They have potent healing capabilities and are naturally knowledgeable about plant life. Those with unicorn energy often associate themselves with plants as herbalists, naturopaths, gardeners, chefs, or mixologists. They are also drawn to the healing arts, and coupled with their infinitely creative abilities, you will often find them in the entertainment industry. They heal with the music they create, the words they write, and the jokes they tell just as easily as they do with herbs and potions. Unicorns are naturally charming and are delightful to be around. Can't talk today. They make playtime fun for children and encourage everyone to freely explore their imagination and creativity. They encourage joy and laughter and fun and help the adults who take themselves a bit too seriously to get back in touch with their inner child. They help illuminate blocks and obstacles to accessing one's own creative powers and potential, and to explore new opportunities in life. Unicorns are natural visionaries and see the truth in everything. Those who seek clarity would do well to seek the wisdom of a unicorn, as they cut through illusions and encourage one to see the bigger picture. While unicorns teach one to see the beauty in all life, their ability to see through everyone and everything is exceptional and impeccable, which is another reason they make such fantastic companions, as they serve as both protectors and guardians. Unicorns mature but never age, making them essentially immortal. Those with unicorn energy make good parents and are highly relatable. They light up a space in a positive way. Unicorns are very humble beings, and while they easily make friends and can be social, as spiritual beings they like to spend some quality time on their own to recharge and nurture their own spiritual energy. For those on a spiritual journey who are attuned to unicorns, you will find your path enlightening and illuminating with much adventure, as well as opportunities to play and have fun. You will also likely find yourself feeling at home in forests. Meditations will likely come most easily there as well, as it is the natural habitat of unicorns. They are possibly the only magical creature that is not originally based on human fears. Unicorns are not monsters. They are revered and respected. They are strong, solitary animals who seek to do good for all around them. Never did a unicorn pose a threat to a human, or indeed any other creature that does not seek to harm them first. Unicorns have no one detailed mythology, as many cultures believe them to be real, though many now speculate that myths started with the sightings of the rhino or narwhal, or cave paintings depicting a horned ox or goat from the side, so it looked like they had a singular horn. The horn of a unicorn is called an alicorn, like A-L-I-C-O-R-N. On the screen. And was said that drinking from one could help you detect and even heal from poison. Their eyes are usually depicted as light blue, light pink, purple, deep blue, or brown. A baby unicorn is known as a sparkle, which is fucking adorable. And touching a pure white unicorn was said to bring luck. They were drawn to the pure, so there were tales of hunters using young female virgins as bait to lure the unicorn out of hiding. But this is, of course, fiction. You don't have to be pure and chaste to work with unicorns in your practice. Apparently April 9th is National Unicorn Day in a few cultures, so this may be the best day to make an initial connection. And in China, the unicorn is known as the Qi Lin. That was like a couple of random facts that I managed to squeeze in there. Searching for a unicorn won't necessarily lead you to one, as they will always find you. Unicorns come from an ascended star called Lacuma? Lacuma? Lacoma? I don't know. Oh, on the screen. Near the Sirius constellation, which is supposedly where the fairy realm, or the unicorn kingdom within the fairy realm, resides. A unicorn knows when you are ready to receive it and will make its presence known, usually in dreams or meditations. These beings hold a high place in the hierarchy, as they belong to the angelic family, thus working at a very high frequency. The unicorn kingdom is overseen by the King and Queen Unicorn, hallowed beings in direct contact with the archangels. Unicorns work within the light and are able to move through and within all dimensions and universes. Unicorns offer love, hope, inspiration, awakening, enlightenment, nurturing, and protection. It will usually respond to offerings and let you know of its presence by leaving a white feather. Unicorns love gardens and all natural settings, as they love the peace to be found there. However your unicorn appears to you, know it is there to enhance your life. A unicorn's horn is an energy conduit filled with light, love, enlightenment, spiritual power, insight, healing, and wisdom. Unicorns usually have one white or pastel-coloured horn, but occasionally you'll come across one with a golden horn, meaning they are older, more elevated, wiser, and have worked with light energy for longer. Unicorns often appear during the most trying times of our lives, and their role is to help us navigate the often difficult journey of life. The unicorn's energy allows you to see the divine in all things. They work to help you attain exactly what your soul needs, hearing your wishes and your prayers. They reside in the fairy realm and help to guard it and keep it in balance and harmony. So with, like, they work to guard it with the dragons, basically. So dragons and unicorns are like the guardians of the fairy realm. Unicorns have heightened senses and can smell emotions, can hear music and everything, and are very sensitive to loud noises. They reside in the seventh dimension and respect the dictates of humans. The Atlanteans were well known to work with unicorns. Unicorns see in light energy. They are also associated with the goddess Diana or Artemis, and she was said to have a chariot drawn by seven white unicorns. Look up your mythology on that one. Their element is light. The crystals you can offer to them are, or like good ideas to start with, are quartz, fluorite, rose quartz, opalite, angelite, amethyst, apophyllite, larimar, aquamarine, lepidolite, peridot, and spirit quartz. Their season is spring. Their tarot suit is pentacles. The colours that they're associated with are white, pink, purple, any kind of pastel colour or rainbow colours, and black, I think. It says black. The offerings you can give to them are rose petals, white flowers, heart-shaped objects, candles, glitter, unicorn statues or plushies, unicorn imagery, music, bells, laughter, fragranced oils, incense, wind chimes, chanting, dancing, and kind and loving and positive thoughts. So, unicorn information done. Have I ever worked with unicorns? I did when I was a kid. I had a unicorn plushie that I named Corny, and it was blue, and I got him for Christmas, and my uncle spilled coffee on him that day. So he was a blue unicorn with a patch of brown, and I had him for a very long time. He used to protect me from my nightmares, and I think I connected with the unicorn energy a lot back then. I was obviously much more imaginative as a child and connected much easier with fairy energy, or like fey being kind of energy. And yeah, connected quite a lot with unicorns as a kid. But more recently, like since I started working with the fae again and like being all super witchy, recently I feel like I've sent them around, but I've never, well, like not since I was a kid, I haven't actually worked with them directly. I haven't had any contact with them, and I haven't really tried to reach out to them, I don't think, because I think I just had this thing in my head where, like, I used to be such a girly girl as a kid, and unicorns kind of came in part of that, and then when I got more a bit more tomboyish when I was in my teens, I kind of dropped out of all of that kind of stuff, with all of, like, the pink and the unicorns, and never really got out of contact with fairies, because... But unicorns kind of fell to the wayside, as did all of my other girly shit, so it's... I'm picking some of it back up now, and I'm able to see that even if it is considered really childish and girly and stuff like that, and even if it seems kind of like out of character for me and like to who I kind of like know myself to be now, it's still could be useful in my craft and can help me improve myself, and that's what my craft is all about. So having said that, I believe that wraps up this video. Be unapologetically you, no shame, and I will see you in the next one.